हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई थिंक यू ऑल आर वेल एंड गुड, सेफ एट योर होम। सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर डूइंग मोशन चैप्टर। इन दैट चैप्टर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू दैट व्हाट इज मोशन। आई हैव टोल्ड दैट द फिनोमिना ऑफ चेंज ऑफ पोजिशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू सराउंडिंग्स एंड टाइम इज कॉल्ड मोशन। ओके, देन आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू रेस्ट। इफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट नीड नॉट चेंज इट्स स्टेट हैविंग स्टेशनरी एट वन प्लेस, देन दैट स्टेट इज कॉल्ड रेस्ट। ओके, देन वी हैव डन फिजिक्स। वट इज फिजिक्स? द ब्रांच ऑफ साइंस विच डील विद द नेचुरल फिनोमिनाज। ओके, देन आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज। While physical quantities are categorized in scalar and vector, I have explained that the scalar quantities are the quantities which required only magnitude to express them, whereas vector quantity required magnitude as well as direction to express them. Okay, up to here we have completed, and now today we are going to start the next terms which are used in this chapter, that is distance. And we know that distance is a scalar quantity. First of all, you should know whether it is scalar or vector. It need not require any direction to express itself. Therefore, it is considered to be a scalar quantity. Okay? If anything is moving in one direction, isn't it? So that direction, when direction is involved, then it is called displacement, and till the direction is not involved, then it is called distance. I will explain you with the help of one example. For example, I will take here a point O. This O is called reference point. What it is called? A reference point. In every path we have one reference point, or I can say the reference point is the point where an object starts its motion. Okay, start changing in its direction. Okay, for example, O is a point, and from O an object moves O to A, isn't it? And when, for example, it is 10 kilometer, then again from A it started and go to the position B. Okay, let us assume this is 5 kilometers. So if I have to measure the distance traveled by this object, so what should I do? I will write here distance traveled is equal to OA plus AB, isn't it? What is OA? OA is 10 kilometer, and what is AB? AB is 5 kilometer, isn't it? So it will be 15 kilometer. So the total distance traveled by an object will be 15 kilometer. Okay, if I say that again it will move from here to here, for example the C position, and it comes back to O. Let us assume this is 20 kilometer and it is 5 kilometer. Now I am explaining you displacement. As the definition of displacement speaks, it tells the shortest distance between the initial position and the final position. If I say this is the final initial position, our object start from here and get again end up here only, isn't it? So the final position and initial position in this case is same. If I minus, or if I write difference from final to initial, then the displacement will be zero. Means from wherever it has started, it again reaches that point, so the displacement become zero. The very important things regarding distance and displacement is that the distance and displacement can be equal, the displacement can be zero, the distance traveled cannot be zero, and always the distance travel is greater than the displacement. It will not be more than the displacement, isn't it? As you know that it is the shortest distance between final and initial, so always it will be less than the distance traveled. So I think the distance, reference point and displacement is clear to you. Now come to the SI unit. What will be the SI unit of this? So the SI unit of distance is meter, and here also same, the SI unit of displacement is also meter. So distance and displacement is clear to you. Now let us move further to do uniform motion and non-uniform motion. As the name suggests, uniform, so it means the motion, the equal, in which equal distance is traveled in equal interval of time, so that motion is known as uniform motion. I repeat once again, uniform motion is the distance traveled by any object, equal distance traveled by any object in equal interval of time. This uniform motion, I can have one example for you people. For example, we have car 1 or car A, we have car B, they both are moving, and let us assume the time taken by it. The first distance traveled by the car A is 5 kilometers in 1 hour. Okay, then 10 kilometers in another hour, 1 hour, then 15 kilometers in hour 3, then 20 kilometers again in hour 4. But you see, the difference between this is 5, the total difference between this is also 5, the total difference is also 5. So equal distance was traveled by car A, and if I say the in between this 1 and a time interval is also 1. So when equal distance is traveled in equal interval of time, then it is said to be, then object is said to be in uniform motion. I think now it is clear to you. Now come to non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion, which was explained by car B. For example, first it travel 5 kilometers, then it travel 12 kilometers, then again it travel 15 kilometers, then 20 kilometers. Do you find the same interval in between this 12, 7 here? It will be 3 here and it will be 5 here. 7, 3 and 5, they are not equal distance traveled by car B in equal interval of time. So such type of motions are called non-uniform motion. Again I repeat, if any object travels unequal distance in equal interval of time, then it is said to be in non-uniform motion. You can have many other example also of uniform motion and non-uniform motion. Okay, you can, if suppose a car is moving and it was due to heavy traffic jam, it cannot go further. So that will be example of uniform motion or non-uniform motion. Sometimes the speed will be more, sometimes the distance covered will be less, isn't it? So it will be the case of non-uniform motion. Okay, the speeding up or slowing down vehicle are the example of non-uniform motion. I think the non-uniform and uniform motion is clear to you. So In our next video, we will do what is speed, what is velocity, and what is the SI unit of speed and velocity, and many more terms related to it. Thank you. Till now, thank you, and have a nice day.